Hi, I'm Charlie Memminger, Hawaii Community Outreach Coordinator for CCA, America's leader in partnership corrections. For about 10 years, CCA has shared a unique partnership with Hawaii, which includes a state-of-the-art correctional facility in Arizona, built exclusively for Hawaii inmates. In this video, you'll learn more about Saguaro Correctional Center and the Hawaii inmates who live there.
Saguaro Correctional Center was built in 2007 in Eloy, Arizona, as part of a partnership between CCA and the state of Hawaii. About an hour's drive from Phoenix, Saguaro was built specifically to house Hawaii inmates. Like many states who partner with CCA, Hawaii faces a shortage of prison beds, and because of challenging economic times, has not been able to build new prisons. By partnering with CCA, Hawaii has been able to safely house Hawaii inmates in a medium security, state-of-the-art facility that offers a variety of rehabilitative programs while incorporating aspects of Hawaii's unique cultural lifestyle into daily life at Saguaro. Building and operating a prison in Hawaii is very costly to Hawaii taxpayers. We know how valuable land is on the beautiful islands. So from a cost standpoint, the benefit of Saguaro is that Hawaii saves millions of dollars every year on prison costs. These cost savings can go to other important taxpayer needs on the islands, like improving schools, building hospitals, and other public projects to protect the islands. There are about 1,800 Hawaii inmates in Saguaro, and another 55 in the nearby CCA Red Rock Correctional Center, separated from the main population because of personal conflicts or special security issues. CCA's mission in caring for the Hawaii inmates is first and foremost to ensure safety within the prisons. CCA works hard so inmates and staff alike feel very safe. Providing fair and humane treatment to these men is of utmost importance. CCA staff know these men personally and strive to have open communication. The CCA prisons are immaculately clean, with lots of paintings on the walls, bright lights, and open corridors. The housing areas are large and open. The classrooms look like schools, and the medical center looks like a new doctor or dentist's office. At Saguaro, life revolves around continuing education, trade and vocational instruction, rehabilitation programs, religious and cultural study, physical recreation, and dining. And there is an element of Hawaii island life that permeates these activities. During the summer months, Warden Todd Thomas and many of the prison staff wear aloha shirts to reflect the spirit of Hawaii at Saguaro. Warden Thomas ensures that Saguaro offers a culturally sensitive environment for Hawaii inmates, including a menu approved by Hawaii to ensure seasonings, recipes, and cooking styles blend well with Hawaii tradition and culture. Saguaro's weekly menu may include rice, shoyu chicken, fish, spam, stir-fried pork, or local moko burgers. Special meals and seasonal foods are served during Hawaii holidays and celebrations such as makahiki. Each year, Hawaii inmates participate in the opening and closing of makahiki, a traditional celebration of Thanksgiving with Hawaiian music, special foods, and fellowship. Hawaii inmates also participate in recognizing celebrations such as Prince Kohio Day and King Kamehameha Day. Some Saguaro inmates may also participate in a Hawaiian spiritual and cultural group.
We've been given a chance to do our ceremonies.
Hawaiians are allowed to participate in a couple of cultural events throughout the year, and they've even participated in some of the other cultural events with other populations.
I participate in the Hawaiian Spiritual and Culture Group. We try to reconnect with our ancestors and try to gain what we lost.
Because most of these inmates will eventually re-enter society in Hawaii, programs for personal, professional, and educational improvement are the main focus of life in Saguaro. Inmates take part in a variety of educational opportunities, from learning to read and finishing high school to starting college courses. Math, writing, and even Hawaiian language classes are available. In large modern classrooms and shops, inmates learn carpentry, plumbing, electrical contracting, and computers.
I came directly from Halawa Correctional Facility, which is the prison in Hawaii, to this facility. I'm one of the few individuals that requested to be transferred out of state. I have a life sentence, and the living conditions up here are a lot easier. They allow us different privileges than we're allowed back home. We're offered more programs. I'm an undergraduate at Central Arizona College, studying for business administration. But prior to that, I participated in the life skills program. I've gone and graduated that twice. I was a part of the Second Chance Canine program. We train dogs for elderly people mainly, service dogs. Computer classes. I pretty much participate in programs to keep myself busy and out of trouble.
Visitors to Saguaro are often surprised at some of the more innovative programs. One of the most unique programs is the Second Chance at Life Greyhound program, in which rescued racing greyhound dogs live with inmates in their housing units. The dogs provide companionship and a sense of responsibility for the inmates, while the inmates train the dogs for eventual adoption by outside families. The Greyhound program provides hope and emotional healing to the greyhounds, as well as the inmates.
I think it's a good program for correctional facilities because for those inmates that are getting out soon, they can pick up a skill, whether they want to volunteer at a shelter or try to open their own business for training or rescue dogs, but also for the general population. They also get to live with the dogs and interact with the dogs.
The dog program provides an avenue or affords me the opportunity to give service back to the community, back to the dogs. A selfless act that provides training where these dogs will go on and become a cherished family pet.
Saguaro is a long way from Hawaii, but CCA bridges the miles by making it easy for family members when in Arizona to personally visit with inmates, even on short notice. Live video conferencing is also available weekly between inmates and their family and friends in Hawaii.
We offer the inmates contact visitation, non-contact visitation, and a special visitation. We offer video visitations and video conferencing and stuff for the Hawaiian inmates.
At Saguaro, inmates are encouraged to practice their personal spiritual, religious, and cultural beliefs. This includes everything from dancing in hula halaus, traditional Hawaiian hula groups, to organized prayer services. Outside religious and spiritual organizations are welcome into the facility as well. Hawaii's New Hope Ministry has begun to reach out to Hawaii's inmates with visits to the prison. Last year, New Hope held a service at Saguaro attended by more than 900 inmates, including 175 who asked to be baptized. Along with daily recreational and cultural activities, Saguaro inmates are also treated to occasional special events, such as the annual Concert in the Yard, which features musical groups comprised of inmates from the prison's music room, who perform for the facility staff and inmates. Concert in the Yard is not only a way for musically inclined inmates to exhibit their talents, but it's also a way to motivate fellow inmates to get involved in the music program. The concert was inspired by the recognition that music is a large part of Hawaiian culture.
Just about all the inmates at Saguaro eventually will re-enter the island community. As you can see, CCA's partnership with Hawaii allows the state to save money and rehabilitate inmates while respecting their unique culture. Thank you for watching. Aloha.